Then is the disciples, let us pass over onto the other side. Tell somebody, let us pass over.
Let us pass over.
Say it again, let us pass over.
Let us pass over.
To the other side.
He
said to the disciples, let us pass over to the other side. So the disciples gave that instruction, and it was 36 days, and when they had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship, and there were also with him other little ship. Verse 37, and there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. Verse 38, and he was in the hinder or part of the ship, asleep on a pillow, and they awakened and said unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says that when the evening was come, it was Jesus initiated. He said to them, let us pass on to the other side. And the Bible says, and the disciple took him as he was. There was no formal preparation, so they just take him the way he was. There was no change, there was no dress up, there was no makeup. They took him even as he was, just as he was, and decided to take him along because he had said, let us go to the other side. Every time you are about to step into another dimension, there will be a storm.
Amen.
I help you talk to somebody, so there will be a storm.
Amen.
Every time, if you're going to step into another dimension of life, it is possible, as we are talking here, that many, when we talk about running, like many would have already settled their case. Many are already in a very comfortable position. But if you are like me, you are agitating for something more. Tell somebody, there's going to be a storm. Let me talk to you and say there's going to be a storm. And so the Bible said that there arose a storm, and the disciples were trying to contain the storm. They were trying to, handle it by themselves. And the Bible says that as the mother tried it, the storm was so much that the boat began to be full of water. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, you are not going to be able to read in life by your own effort. Tell somebody, you're not going to be able to reign in life by your own effort. It's not going to be by your strength. It's not going to be by your education. It's not going to be by your qualification. It's not going to be by your background. If you're going to reign in this life, it's not going to be because of who you are. Because, who you are, is not enough to contend with the storms of this life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What you have is not enough to stop the storms of life. If you walk around a little bit and open your eyes, if you think that you have financial problem, it does not help you to live in life, because there are folks with millions of rents in your bank, but they are not really in life. They are lying right now under the oxygen that you have it free, trying to get it for a price. Nobody's talking to you right now.
Amen.
So you're not going to reign in this life because of who you are and what you have. So the Bible said the disciples were trying to contain the storm. And as much as they tried to contain the storm, the boat was getting full. Until they realized the one that says, let us go to the other side. Tell somebody, until you come to the point in time in your life that you acknowledge that Jesus is the Lord of your life.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just a church cliche. It's not just something that we say in church and lift up hands and feel a little bit happy. Oh, Jesus is my Lord. Hallelujah. That's not what it means. Now, until you come to the point in time where you understand that Everything that you think that you have, you've been given. So personal effort is not going to help us to reign in life until you come to the point where you truly acknowledge that He is with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible says they come to the point in time and the Peter cries and Master, don't you care? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't you care that we are perishing? Master, is it not that doesn't concern you at all? Master, don't you see how much we have prayed? Master, don't you see how much I have been faithful with my tithes and offering? Master, don't you see how much I have done for the church? But they're not like any of this.
Amen.
Amen.
Master, don't you care? Because, you know, because there have been times when you are on using your personal effort to try to reign in life. What will be a lot of the Lord? There comes a time that you will be so frustrated that even the Master is there, he seems not to do something. Because he needs to be acknowledged. He needs to be appreciated until you come to the point. Some of us will never get to the next level of life until you come to the point where you acknowledge that the Master is in the house. Hallelujah. Until you come to the point in time where you cease from your own efforts. Because the Bible says it is not by works of righteousness, lest any man should boast. The problem of the church is that we have carried the mentality of the world to the church. We are using the system, the world system in the church. What does the world system? The world system, the more you study hard, the more you work hard, the more your life will be better. How many of you ever heard that? Oh, come on now. Am I talking to me, folks in the church?
Amen.
If you're going to make it, you're going to study. Have not your parents told you that? You're going to study hard. You're going to work hard. You're going to do this hard. So you have all imbibed that principle of trying to make it by yourself. Now, I'm not against hard work. I love hard work. Amen.
Amen.
Have you not heard it say, no pain, no gain? How many of you said that? So no pain, no gain. You know you're going to do it. You're going to fight for it. You're going to do this. But, you know, that's not God's system. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's not the system of God. That's not the system that will make you reign in life. That's not the system. You are using the world system in the kingdom of God. So they were using their own effort. If you read this story in another of the gospel, the Bible said they were scooping the water out of the boat, you know, trying to keep the boat afloat. They were doing everything to make sure the boat is not sinking. But the Bible said, the more the trial, am I speaking to somebody? The more you seem to struggle in life, the more you try to keep it together, it looks like it is tearing apart. The more you walk up, come on. So the Bible said, they were working very hard, trying to make it happen. As some of you understand how much you have put into that relationship, you're trying to make it work.
Amen.
They are trying. with the world system. I am forced in the kingdom of God. I operate it by the world system. Hallelujah. And you're operating with the principle of the world. The world says the more you walk, no pain, no gain. And you have that mentality. And you come to God with that mentality. Have you not heard what the scripture said? It said your righteousness is as filthy rags. There is nothing that you have to do to qualify. There's nothing that the Bible says, Paul said, it is by grace. Any man should boast. I've been here because I did this and I did that. If it was not what I did, I wouldn't have been here. God said, no, that's not what it is. In the kingdom of God, it is not by walking, it is by receiving. Yes. Do you understand me? It is not by walking, it is by receiving. The greatest that we have is to be able to receive. Jesus said, it is finished. So if it is finished, why are you trying to walk what is not there? If the job has been finished, why are you walking? So all you need to do is to receive. And all you need to do, our God, is to acknowledge your healing has been finished. Lacks the ability to receive. Because we are here with a mentality of walking. I have walked. I am entitled to. And the more we come to God with that attitude, the more He deny us. Because it's not by works anymore. It is by works I don't merit. All what I need to do is to lift up my hands and receive and say it is finished. It is finished. You have to walk. I have already walked it. The problem is that many forces in the church are trying to walk what has already been walked. It is finished. But we are just in the mechanics and trying to walk. You cannot walk to get there. You cannot walk to get into life. Living in life is by receiving Him who has read. Let's look at this scripture. Maybe you will understand me. From the book of Romans, chapter number 5, verse 17. Romans chapter 5. Because if we don't understand this, we're not going to be able to reign in life. The power to reign is based entirely on Jesus Christ. We are designed to reign in life because Jesus is the Lord of our life. Hallelujah. Look at the book of Romans chapter number 5 and verse 17. Romans chapter 5 verse 17. Hallelujah. Amen. Romans chapter 5 verse 17. The Bible says in Romans chapter 5 verse 17. It said, if, somebody said, if. It said, for if by one man offense, death reigned by one. It's not on the screen yet. I'm trying to find out. But I'm reading from my script because I had to. I maybe anticipated this. For if by one man offense, death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by love, Jesus. Let's see it then. Go back to verse 17. Let's start from there, verse 17. For if by one man offense, death reigned by one, much more they which receive. Somebody say receive. Tell somebody receive. Receive abundance of what? Grace. And what? The gift of righteousness. Someone said the gift. Tell somebody the gift of righteousness. Righteousness that qualifies you to reign is a gift. Righteousness that qualifies you to reign is a gift. Grace means I did not qualify. I do not merit it. But it was given to me anyway. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I was given, the Bible said, if by one man, he's talking about Adam. If by Adam, death reigned throughout the entire human race. So it is that by one man, Christ Jesus, life and righteousness, and we can reign with Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell somebody you can reign.
You can reign.
So when we are talking about reigning in 2016, it is not just a new concept. I said it last night, you know, God. God designed you to reign in life.
Amen. Amen.
He designed you to reign above sickness.
Amen.
He designed you to reign above poverty.
Amen.
He designed you to be a ruler. He said, let us take man in our own image. And let man have dominion. Let him rule and subdue, oh Lord Jesus.
Amen.
He said, but we in the end, when man fell, the Bible said, when man fell, because of one man, he could not reign. God sent his son Jesus Christ so that by the second Adam, Christ Jesus, we can reign.
Amen.
And all what we need to do is to receive. That's all we
receive.
You need to receive the gift of righteousness. You see, when you receive that gift, you see, sometimes the enemy plays with the mind. That because you failed yesterday, you are not righteous. See, once you receive the gift of righteousness, you are righteous.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I'm not sure.
Amen. Amen.
Because I did not become righteous by what I did. So I don't have to do anything to continue to be righteous. I just need to maintain my gift.
Amen.
Amen.
Tell somebody maintain your gift.
Amen.
You don't have to. Just maintain what you have received.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maintain your gift. There are many that have reigned in life. When you understand this principle, that in you there is a master.
Yes.
Who has finished every work for you.
Amen.
The sheep is you. The storm is the world system.
Amen.
The world is attacking you here and there.
Yes.
And all what you do, you're acting like Peter, trying to scoop water out of your life, trying to solve one problem. And all what you need to do is to receive him that is already inside.
Amen.
All what you need to do is to acknowledge about the feeding of the 5,000. I mean, this is the same Jesus they've been with together. They've seen so many things. Lazarus has been brought back to life after 4 days of being buried in nothing. A baby's lunch, a boy's lunch, has been used to feed 5,000. So how come am I crying? I don't have. Keep it quiet. So how come am I stressed and depressed? Where did I get that from? Are we not just acting like the same Peter? He said, have them together. Let everybody sit down. They are hungry. And you say, I don't know how we're going to get money to feed all the folks. And Jesus said, and somebody come up. Philip said, Master, among all these people that are here, these 5,000 men, assuming that they all have one more wives, and all the family planning, they have only 3 children. Because it was just men, they didn't count the women. 5,000 men. And Philip, they said, you know, among these 5,000 for this, you know what? All of these people, there's only one boy that has a lunch box. Only one more that has a lunch box. And Jesus said, let him sit down. We're going to feed them. He said, okay, let's see how you do it. And the Bible said, he took the boy's lunch and lifted it up. He said, thank you, Father. And he gave it to them. And the Bible said, they feed 5,000 men and they have 12 baskets left over. Mm-hmm. So then, another time they saw 4,000 being fed. So how come they are in the storm and they don't wake up the master? Because you're operating with the same mentality like us. We're going to work it out. We're going to try to make it happen. They fail to acknowledge the greater one that is on the inside. Amen. So where is your stress coming from? How come you have sleepless nights? Mm-hmm. You come to church, you are dozing off because you didn't sleep in the light. Mm-hmm. Counting the ceiling of your problems. Mm-hmm. How come you stress financially? How come you stress when the master is in the boat? The same way they were acting. Developing high blood, low blood, no blood. My BP, people even have BP. I thought BP was a filling station where they put for you. My BP. I thought it was a gas station where they put, you know, refuel gas. My BP is high. I'm stressed. Depressed. How come? Where did it come from? When the master is in the boat, because we are using the world system. His name is rich.
Amen.
The work has been completed. Your healing is finished.
Amen.
He's not going to heal you, he has healed you already. If you are going to reign in 2016, you need to acknowledge one, amen. Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They shall reign in life by one, Jesus. Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want Jesus Christ. Not by any money, not by education, not by your culture, not by your academics. The only way, not by your skill, the only way you're going to reign in life is by one, Jesus Christ. Somebody say Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
You need to acknowledge him.
Amen.
Jesus is the word of God. Many people have reigned in life. Time will not allow me to talk about somebody like Moses. Before he took Moses on the journey, he told him, he said, I am.
That I am.
Amen. Everything that you need, I am.
Amen.
Whatever you want, I am that thing that you want. Because Moses asked him, what is your name? I need to know your name. I'm not going to go until you tell me who you are.
Amen.
And God looked at him and said, I am. That I am.
Amen.
Anything you want, that's what I will be.
Amen.
Ah. Amen. Oh, you didn't hear me well. Amen. Anything you want, he was telling Moses, you can reign like I reign.
Amen.
You can be I am. To reign in every circumstance. So the Bible said, after all of that miracles, Moses is confronted by the Red Sea. And Moses is shaking his trousers. Is this my new trousers? Don't make any bread. Moses is shaking. Standing at the Red Sea, the Bible said that Pharaoh's army were coming with fury. Moses, what are we going to do? Where is the way? Have you seen no other way? They are very close. Look at them coming. They are very angry. And the Bible has said that they have taken all the gold from Egypt. They said, it's not only their firstborn, this thing that will come from them. And God said to Moses, stand still. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, stand still.
Stand still.
You have a living God.
Amen.
You serve a living God.
Amen.
He has made you to reign.
Yes.
In this life.
In this
you need not be afraid.
You
need not worry.
Stand still.
And you will see the salvation of God. And God said to Moses, what do you have? Because I don't use what you don't have.
Amen.
I'm not a magician. Anything you have is useful to me. You don't understand. If you can just smile, it will open the door. If it's all what you have is a smile, if all what you have is a catwalk, whatever you have, if anyone with something in the house, what do you have? Moses, what do you have in your hand? Moses said, this thing, he cannot even make a ferry, not to talk of a boat. How bad? He said, what do you have in your hand? He said, you know it's a stick. He said, stretch it forward, because you are a king. And the moment you obey, the Bible said, the Red Sea parted into two. I don't know what is standing before you, but Moses reigned. You are not education. Whatever. If you only have one shoe, it's enough to do it.
Amen.
If you only have a shirt, it's enough to do it.
Amen.
It's about what you have.
Amen.
God is not putting a stress on you. Ask someone, what do you have?
Amen.
You are about to win. So when I'm talking about winning in life, somebody say, yo, as units are open, after close admission in units, I didn't finish my degree. Your heart degree is going to make you win. It's not giving you a problem. proven in the Bible.
Amen.
That it is possible to reign. Some people break jail without toy toy. Some people break jail without God. I'm talking about Paul and Silas. Joshua took over from Moses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He took over from Moses. And the Bible says, I think it's in Joshua chapter 12. He said, it came to pass that as the battle was strong, the sun was going down. The sun was going down. It was about to be night. That speak to me with somebody who said, I'm already too old. And my son is already going down. I'm too old to get married. I'm too old to study on.
Yeah.
The things that were dead in your life are about to wake up.
Yeah.
he was laying there.
Amen.
In the bedroom, he tossed the bones, began to wake up, and began to leave. Tell somebody, I will not die.
I will not die
until I fulfill my dreams. Say it with all this.
I will not die until I fulfill.
Say it again. I will not die. Let's see how it's going to come out. The Bible says Daniel, the conspired, threw him into the lions. Dead. Hungry lions. Lions that were, and they were so sure that before he left there, they'll catch him by the neck. Ask that American that went to Lion's Park. I'll be dangerous. Then nobody knew. Because there was somebody that was inside. He was not afraid. Then nobody. And the lion stood.
Do you want to reign? There's somebody
that has already reigned on your behalf. All what you need to do is to acknowledge him. Master, don't you care that we perish? Because what you've been struggling with has already been taken care of. And the Bible says, he's strong. He said, peace, be still. The wind and the storm said, yes, sir. They became quiet. All what you need to do is just stand up right now and the storm that is brewing in your life is still. He is on my inside.